31, I had a question on section 6.7, number 49, and here we're asked to look at the earthquake magnitude formula again, and we're told that one earthquake has a magnitude of 3.9, and then we're told that a second earthquake has 750 times as much energy as the first earthquake, and can we find that magnitude? So if I take a step back, I'm going to find a magnitude of a stronger earthquake, right? It's got 750 times as much energy. Okay, fantastic. And can I figure out its magnitude? So I'm definitely going to be using this formula. So what I need to figure out is what I'm going to plug in for S. If you recall, and it's been a little while, we haven't looked at this since earlier in chapter 6, but this S sub 0 here, that's just the minimal amount of energy or the minimum amount of energy we can measure that's released by an earthquake. So let's start to play with this formula. And I know that when I ultimately find this magnitude, it's got to be larger than 3.9, but how much larger is going to be the question. So in order to make this work, I just need to think more about these seismic moments. And let me go ahead and write down that S, we call that a seismic moment. Right, we're measuring the amount of energy released, so seismic moment. All right, so then let's take a look at this. So if I talk about the seismic moment for this first earthquake, the one that was the 3.9, I don't know the amount of energy released. It didn't give me an actual number, but I'll just call that S sub 1 for the first earthquake. Oops. And then what I know based on the wording of this question or the way this question was set up is that S sub 2 is 750 times as much as S sub 1. So I have this little formula right here. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to use the fact that we do know one of the magnitudes, the Richter scale number for this first earthquake, and we're going to work ourselves backwards into the into the magnitude of the second earthquake. So let's take a look at this. So from the first earthquake, we know the Richter number, right? Or we know the magnitude, right? It's 2/3 log whatever S sub 1 is in ratio to S sub 0, right? So this earthquake's seismic moment in ratio to the smallest seismic moment that we can actually measure, the smallest amount of energy we can measure. Okay, we also know from the second earthquake, we don't know its Richter number, but we do know its seismic moment is 750 times that of the first earthquake. Okay, so now keep in mind that we want to find M. This is our end game. Can we find the magnitude of that second earthquake? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mess with this a little. So I'm going to use some properties of logarithms, and here we go. So if we take a look at this argument in here, the 750 S sub 1 divided by S sub 0, I can rewrite that. So let me mess with that. I can take 750 S sub 1. Whoa, what was that? Let me get my eraser. I don't know how. Sometimes this thing makes odd shapes, and I'm not sure how that triangle got made. So 750 S sub 1 in ratio to S sub 0, I can make this 750 times S sub 1 over S sub 0. All right, so you're allowed to manipulate the fractions that way. And the reason that I want to do that is because I want to use properties of logarithms. When my logarithm is a product, I can use the product property. So I can say this is 2/3 times the log of 750 plus the log of S sub 1 over S sub 0. Right? And then you see me here just distributing the 2/3. So, okay. But the thing is, once I do that, if we take a look at this expression here, this 2/3 log S sub 1 to S sub 0, we actually already know from the first equation that is equal to 3.9. And that's why you see me subbing that in. Oops, excuse me. That's why you see me subbing that in right here. So that's why I have this 3.9 right here. And then the cool thing is that you can see that this other logarithm that's hanging out is just a number that I can crunch in my calculator, and that's what I did. So when I calculated 2/3 log of 750, I got 1.917. I add that all up, and we round our, we usually round our Richter numbers, I would say, to 5.8, but this said go ahead and do it to the nearest hundredth. So I went to 5.82. But I did want us to like think about this for a moment, right? The Richter number only jumped by about 2 points, right? It went from 3.9 to 5.8, but this earthquake was 750 times as intense. And that's just a testament to logarithms. Logarithms, we know their graph looks like this, right? It's really slow going and off to the right, which means as your x values get larger and larger and larger, right? As I move this way along the x-axis, your y values only go up by a little. So what logarithms can do is they can take really, really large numbers here on the x-axis and they just shrink them down to small y values. And so that's one of the uses of logarithms, right? It keeps the scale intact, right? As x increases, the y values increase. It's just that they increase, these y values increase so much more slowly than the x values. So logarithmic growth, it can really slow things down. All right, so there's number 49. Thanks so much, everyone. Bye.